All right, guys. So I noticed my BitX was running, but my LCD screen has gone totally dark. And I did try to restart it, but it to no avail. So the first thing we're going to check is make sure that you're running the latest firmware for both the BitX and also for the OS on your computer or your phone. But the one thing you want to check as well is the power. So make sure to unplug the power and actually separate the block. See the green button, the green light? You want to just unplug that and wait for that green light to die. Make sure it die and then plug it back in and see if that doesn't rectify the issue. And there it is. Okay, so the screen is actually perfect. I just had to kill the power, but also make sure that that green light goes off on the power bar. And it seems to have corrected the problem with the LCD. But at the same time, make sure that you're running the latest firmware. It's always good to run the latest firmware, and I'll show you how to update your firmware for both the BitX and the website. All right, so we're addressing the problem of having a blank LED screen on the BitX. And the first thing I want to do is make sure I have the latest firmware running on my BitX. But because I've already set up the BitX, I have my IP address already in the memory of my browser. So I'm just going to go straight in there, click on that. And by putting in my IP address, I can pull up the information on my OS dashboard. And what you want to do is come down to settings. Okay. And we want to make sure that we have the latest version. So currently I'm running a 2.45 version. And if I click for the latest release, actually there's a new release and it's a 2.51. So there's two files down here that we're going to download into a folder. And then we're going to update the firmware and we're going to update the website as well. So there's two files at the bottom. You want to click the first one and you want to save that to your downloads folder. And you want to select the bottom one for the website and do the same and save that to your downloads folder. And if you get it unconfirmed in your download, just come up here and say keep and do the same for the other file. Sometimes the Mac will think it's a malicious file and you just have to say keep file. But that'll put the two files in your downloads folder. And then we go to update firmware. We click browse and we're going to go back into our downloads folder and we're going to select the ESP miner option and we're going to update that. You'll see it starts to update over here with a percentage. And then once that's done, we'll be able to update the website.bin file as well. So you want to come over to the website, update website. We're going to click that. We're going to pick up the www.bin file. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to open that. It's going to work for us. And then once it's finished uploading, we will do a restart on the BitX and hopefully that will put things back in order.
All right, guys, just to wrap it up. So we have turned the power off. We did a power recycle and we updated the firmware of the BitX and of the dashboard. And now everything seems to be running A1 and it's hashing, the screen is working, and we're in business. All right. Hope you liked that quick little troubleshooting tutorial and give us a like, subscribe. Lots more content coming.